Welcome to my world. This is Heaven and Earth, playing Minecraft on the PS4. I hope everyone's okay. She's a beautiful thing. I've been, well, managed to do a few hours on Minecraft, quite a few hours. I've been doing quite a bit of work on the old port. Oh, we'll have to go to sleep soon. Right. Quickly, I've extended, we'll go over there in a minute, I've extended the wall from the dock, which is pretty cool. And if we go over here quickly, I also have done, I've moved the river, a little river. Let's just stop, jump out, there we go. So I'll show you up here first, and then we'll go around and have a brief look at what update I've got. Firstly, I have put the water in the cauldrons. Thank you very much for that. So that's always a great addition. And it is going to go dark. So as you can see, I've put a load of dirt down, to bring it up. This bit came up here, so I thought I'm going to have a building here. Let's just collect all this, because what I've been doing here, I've been putting spruce here, so then that way I'll show you the rest of it, why I've needed so much spruce. But I've been chopping it down, putting it in again, chopping it. I've got room for that. No room. So I made it level, because I'm going to put a building here. Maybe I'm thinking the farm might actually go here and cascade it down this way, because I've got ideas for over there with what I've already done. So firstly, I raised it up, so then that way I have a nice gentle walkway. Sorry, if I'm just moving about that quick, it's because it's going dark and the baddies are out. I don't want no creepers to come. There's quite a few creepers which just sneak up on you over there. So I've not decided on a path scheme yet. I've made a little one over there, which I think works quite well. It's just like a random, put a block of cobblestone and the brick, not normal brick, but the stone brick. And I have also been going into the dungeon and just taking some cracked bricks there and some mossy brick there. So as you can see, it used to come roughly around to this point here, because it used to cut in and just go down there. This stream. See, look, there's a baddie there. I don't have a bow on me. Bow's in my chest. So from last time, just made it nice and even. I'm going to put some more terrain up there, put loads of trees down once I've done. And here I'm going to maybe make this a bit narrower, maybe by one block on each side. Then that way I'm going to do a bridge, like a stone bridge across with a roof on it. So then that way I can continue the path across that bit there. So that'll be in the future. The next few episodes, probably two episodes after this one, are going to be to do with this port, because there's going to be, when I think I'm doing, you know, just to put some extra bits in there, the more ideas I've got, and I have to do the ideas. Right, so that's going to be that. Right, without further ado, this is the goods booking in. That's the storeroom, because I've not done a farm yet, which is next on the agenda, because I want to put a load of hay in there and all that kind of good stuff. I thought we need a goods in, you know, where records are kept. So again, similar way I did the structure there, which was the oak wood framework first. I think you can just see it this side. Do the framework first and then just do the rest, which this little bit is just some I used this axe, which is silk touch, just to get the dirt, and then that way I already had some flowers, or I know a couple of flowers are found over there, but yeah, just put them in. I had some bone meal as well, so that helped. And yeah, so let's enter. So this is where the goods booking office. So it's like a little office where the clerk or the master of the port maybe might just stay, or one of his assistants just might stay. Yes, sir. What can I do for you? So that's what that is. I've obviously put nothing in here, just a little bit of a lamp. I am going to put some other things in here. I could do with some ideas of, you know, just some good bits just to put down, maybe a seating area, maybe, because up here, with it being goods booking in, I don't know whether to put like some bookshelves up here, like filing system as they would do. This is obviously slab floor, so then that way I can see the wooden beams, because I like seeing the wooden beams. See the wooden beam there, because the next floor up is slab again, wooden slab, oak slab, pretty sure it's oak, yep. I just think it looks good where you can see the beam, especially in these type of houses. So again, up the ladders to the last floor, and we can see a little bit of anything. Look, there's the castle. Ooh, beautiful. Yeah, so hope that you like that. A big nice arched roof. The houses are going to be similar. Not as big as this, because this is like a state building. It's a administrative building, shall we say. So that's that. Now, before we go anywhere else, I'm going to sleep. Good night. Morning! Top of the morning to you! So, what else have I been up to? What else? So, I'll just have a quick look on this side. Again, with the roof, I've done an opposite contrast to this, or to the wood mill there. I've done the same design. You put the oak and then the spruce on the outside, and it looks quite dapper. Quite dashing, I think. And then stairs, upside down stairs, normal stairs. Just give it, you know, just looks a bit nicer. Nicer? Looks better than what it would normally with just straight brick down. Again, on the side, that's what that looks like. So let's go up here, let's make sure there's no baddies. Nope. I did it close to this, so you can still get by. But, I mean, it's still lit up because of these glowstone. With these trapdoors on. So nothing spawns behind here, so I'm quite happy with that. Yeah. So other than that, let's just go around here. So, like I said before, what the heck is he doing out here? It's not even dark. Hello. Hello, old chap. Your other friends will be dying in the end. I think it's because I've been to the end and I redid. Oh, no. Can't spawn on these though, can he? On the slabs and the stairs. And run away! Right, yeah, so there I'm going to have a farm. I'm pretty much thinking, and I've gathered, I went back to the base and I gathered all the farming bits I could think of, which I've put in this chest here. So a lot of carrots, some potatoes, pumpkins, and the melons, and obviously I need some wheat seed, so that's what that is all there. I mean, this is just anything chest and anything items miscellaneous chest, just dirt and gravel. I mean, the reason why I've got so much dirt and gravel and stuff over here is because with me cutting in and extending everything, I've ended up getting a load of sand as well, so that's going to be good for glass. And this is me wood chest, everything wooden, bushes and bit of wood, bit of seed there, should be in the other chest, but hey. So what will I show you first? I'll show you this first. Now, how I've come about this is because with it being a port, I mean, everyone's seen Pirates of the Caribbean. Excellent film. Love them all. Really great. Always full of action. There's pirates. There's always going to be pirates. We've got a castle with a king there, king's land and everything like that, with a king's port and what have you. And this is like obviously a port as well, the major port. And you're going to have some pirates, so we've got to make sure that any pirates what come, they see these things. Now these are cages. I only just before coming on, I put some pumpkins on there just to imagine if it's a person there, you know. But guys, people been tortured, you know, a bit of a redstone just there, just you know. So these are like just hanging cages to for pirates beware, so to speak. And all they are is stairs. I'll go up the top and then I can show you that way. It's probably better to see it from the top. Here we go. What I've done is I've extended just these logs, just one of these logs, jumping up with the oak. Straight up, and then I've extended this out, and then these are stairs, just four lots of stairs, sorry, six lots of eight stairs in total with a slab, and then I've put the fencing, iron fencing all the way around it, and then slabs at the bottom, and just built them offset. 'Cause if they look even, they kind of don't look like when you see in films, they don't look like that. They're always offset where one's higher than the other. So that's what that is. Quite effective, you pirates, beware. Right, earlier I mentioned about I was just experimenting with some path, and this is just cobblestone and gravel. Just mix it up. Just did the cobblestone first and you know, randomly dig down, dig down, dig down, and you know, put some gravel down. And then this side is the same thing, apart from there's no cobblestone. Again, just experimenting, seeing what looks good. I mean, it's, you know, I could maybe put a dirt block there or something, you know, just to break it up a bit. Maybe. I don't know. Yeah, I keep it there. So yeah, so before last video, the whole thing stopped. I think it was here. Or it was here. I think I stopped it about here. So what I did was, all this is new, all of the barrier, and it all it goes all the way here. So yeah, I've been pretty busy. So you can see where I've cut out where the land was, because I've gone too deep with two blocks deep where the sea is. So this is where all the border was, and I've cut all this out. I mean, you'll see on the last video. So that's, and it just goes around, and I think yes, it ends just there. So that's all the extension I've done for the port. Now these are the gallows. Again, Halloween's only a few days away. It's the 20th today, and there was a thing on 4J Studios where they've announced, yes, the Halo pack's coming on Friday. But not only that, they kept us in suspense, and I was getting excited because I thought, yeah, biomes, yeah. But was it biomes? Was it new update? No. Halloween texture pack, or Halloween mashup pack. So for that, I thought, well, with them being gallows, let's put some pumpkins on there. So I'll show you how I've done this. Basically just a oak trim all the way around with some fencing. Now this was another experimental what looks good type of thing, which it does. Cracked stone bricks from the dungeon, mossy stone bricks and some cobblestone, and it kind of looks really good. I think it looks pretty effective. So yeah, so this build here, that's a bolt. We know what that is. Glowstone. Just in case you're wondering, this is a natural texture pack, because it's the closest thing I can see is medieval. So these are the gallows that stand up. That's an iron. I had one, and call it 1.5 stacks of iron. Where did I find it? It was back. It was back in the main storage area, in the main base. So I've been going all the way around collecting stuff, and there was some as well in the big tower, the Seattle Tower. There was some in there as well, so I managed to gather together some iron blocks. So what this is here is just a metal bit to hold up the rope, and the poor people showing off. Any pirates coming? You know, they can see the people, the prisoners who have been sentenced to death by hanging. Oops, let's get rid of that. So other than that, there's the, and they're off. I just put the gold stone down there, so then just to give it a bit more light. Oh, done it again. Oh, it's because I'm crouched, right? So yeah, so hope you like that. But all it is, it's just a base of, it was spruce, gap, spruce, and then spruce all the way along here. Just to give it a border. This again is slab, so nothing will spawn on this. If anything, they're going to spawn on here, but we've got some lit up pumpkins. Whoa! Because this is torture. This is, you know, just to warn. This is like a meant to be here to warn the pirates off. Because this is what happened to you, boys. Whoa! So I hope that you like the gallows. And then from there I thought, well, if I'm going to have gallows here, I need some other type of corporal punishment here just to show off. Obviously we've got the hanging cages, which I'm going to be putting some more over there. But this, I thought, well, I'm going to elevate this again because it was already elevated, but I did some tidying up and made it like this all the way around. And so I thought, well, what else would they have besides the gallows? They would have a guillotine. So here it is. Again, I've put some, just the experimental flooring, put some gravel in this time, which kind of looks effective. So it's same design, again, like that, all the way around it. And these are the gallows, not the gallows, this is the guillotine. So here, is it going dark? Oh, don't tell me it's going dark. There's no light around here. Sorry, a bit of spillage there. So they'd go there. So you can imagine someone just putting their head down there. And there's the blade. And then this would be the pull. And then the head would roll off. You know, it's imagination. Right, before I show the other bit, I think we need to sleep. Because this section here is prone for creepers, and I don't want to get blown up or anything blown up, so let's sleep. Safety in sleeping. Right, we're back. Right, that's me on the controller just banging it forward twice to run. So yes, so here are the gallows. You pirates, stay away. And here, I'll just show you around it. See, it's all nice, because I thought, because I'm going to it, and it needs to look right, so just spend the time, do it properly. Again, spruce wood, just a spruce down, then 1-2 spruce down, 1-2 spruce down, and then from there, all this is half slab. So I can't put anything on here. Nothing would have spawned on here anyway. The only place to spawn is here and there. Because everything else is basically mob-proof. Apart from that slab there. That's a half slab there. So nothing would actually spawn on this anyway. Which is good. So yeah, so we'll do that again. So yeah. Put your head down there, and then the guy with the scarf over his head, you know, the black scarf, he'll pull the chain, and some poor pirate or something would go on there. So that's that, the guillotine. Now these, I had a look, because I tried all sorts, and I couldn't do it. I couldn't get stocks. So this is what I've come up with now. Just a little bit of a podium. where the person would obviously sit on this bit here, and the head and, well, if it's that way or if it's that way, I don't know. Could stick with the head in the middle, maybe, and stick their arms through. Only by having this, this was the only thing what looked all right. I couldn't see anything which would look good. I mean, I tried using two lots of doors, so then that way I could just use like these single ringlets, but it doubled up. Because no matter which way you had it, either this way or pointing left to right or whichever orientation you used, it didn't look good enough. So I stuck with just putting some normal posts down, spruce posts, and that's what that is. I think it's spruce anyway. Yeah. 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 And then that's the seat, and, you know, someone throws stuff here, you know, apples and what have you, rotten eggs, and that's the stockade, a stockade. I'd like to do some more, try and fit one down there maybe, but just to have it there, just a reminder of what will happen if anyone breaks the king's law. So yeah, so that's pretty cool. Now, what I'm wanting to do here, because we've got the guillotine here, which is the ultimate death sentence, with a bit of theatre and obviously the gallows to warn off pirates and things like that. I'm going to get rid of all this, and I'm going to build like a small like type of prison. And I'm looking at the size, and I'm pretty. See if I do it to here, this is where it's going to cut in. I might even bring this across another 5 and then extend it out, and then that way, like a small building, maybe that size, maybe smaller than that building, the goods in building, but do like you know, this lower bit here, the lower bit first, do the lower bit like one end of it, and then do like a bit of a tower, but doing the tower here, I'm going to do the tower similar to that, but the base of, now that small tower there on the castle, maybe put that down, so then that way it's like an end terrace house type of thing. I'm just describing a building, and like an end house terrace building with a tower on it, so then that way, and also put those cages overhanging on the over the sea as well, because I think, you know, that look cool. You've got to see the stuff like that when you're a pirate or whatever. I can imagine you'd see stuff like that, you know, cages with people over the sea. When I see that, I think either The Hobbit or Lord of the Rings or something like that, there was definitely, I remember seeing something like that in one of those. So yeah, so that's the plan I'm going to be doing next time. I'm going to be doing this prison thing and do a bit of a tower just to finish this side off, because then, you know, got to have a punishment bit and things like that, haven't you? You have to. That's what I thought. You know, it's a port. You got to have some order out of the chaos. Sort all the order out from the chaos, and that's it. That's exactly what it is. Now, because this is the corporal punishment area, or the punishment area, this land would be all. This bit of land here would be what I would say lesser value. So I'm going to be, maybe not next video or the video after, maybe put some poorer houses, like a poorer dwellings here, which then as you go further on, it's more further away from that, and you're coming into the port of where all the money's made and things like that, and build like some bigger houses, so to speak, which then kind of merge in to where the farm would be. So that's the plan. That is the plan. I'm having a real good time building this. I didn't think about I would have as much of a good time building a port than what I have, because there's all these extra bits, like all this area where you know, with the gallows and the guillotine and things, and obviously a wood mill. Obviously a farm will be nice to do, so I can use the resource and put some other blocks up there and fill in what I'm doing. So what I need, if anyone who can who has some good ideas, just for some stuff just to fill in here, the downstairs of the goods in building, you know, what I could put in here, and also floor, this floor and the floor above, you know, just some ideas of what I can put in. Those ideas would help me out, truly. Really, really would. Here, I'm going to maybe put one or two, like, stalls, because goods in, you know. Hold on a minute. See, here, see, I'm going to change this as well. You know, over there where we can get up from the boat, if I jump into this boat here and go sail all the way over there, I can get out. Here, I can't. The only way I can get on here at this moment in time is through this bit here, which is where the shipbuilding part is. And I want to be able to just go in here. So I might change or lower some of this to be like a little bit of a jetty, so I can actually access it rather than just, oh, it looks good. You know what I mean? So it's got purpose, because I like things to have purpose. You know, like, you know I do, because of everything which we did in the castle. It has to have purpose. So other than that, gonna probably, the last bit will be putting in the cobble and what have you. If you like that scheme, just again write it down, and I'll probably do that. But just to have a scheme of a pathway and link it over there, we can go across now. There we go. So yeah, so I've been doing a lot of landscaping. You can imagine how much landscaping. Well, if you have a look at the previous video, you'll see I showed this bit anyway. So literally this bit here was there. So I've moved it all across and built this extra bit here. And I'm going to, I think, do another one of these, but only this high across to here. And then it comes down and have some stairs coming down. So then that way I can have, like, say, a wooden bridge there, maybe. Food for thought. So I hope you like the progress. I'm enjoying doing this. I just hope these blinking updates hurry up, because I really, really want to see the new biomes. I mean, I've got Minecraft on PC, but I want to. Don't get me wrong, you know, I've had a look at the latest snapshot or whatever, you know, with armor stands and things, but I want to do it on the console. I just want to do it all on the console. I'll just go into the castle, because I'm pretty sure there was something I wanted to show you. Oh, because I went over to the other map, back to where the storage is. Hold on, change the subject a minute. Right, this is what I want, just something like that, over there, that second jetty there, just on, look where the cursor is, just there maybe. Have something like this so I can get up. Whoa, what's happened here? We've had a creeper attack. Nightmare. Wonder when that was. Oh, there's something going on here. Oh, there's something really gone wrong here. That was not like that. Joking. Better just check everywhere else. That's not on that. Right, I'll just quickly make sure everything else is alright. I'll quickly show you what I was on about. Yeah, so I managed to, while I was back, I grabbed, is it this way, yeah? I grabbed the other maps, what I had. So these are the maps. This was the original one, this one. And that, hold on. That is where we are now. So that looks pretty cool. See the port of how it looks. Oh, I'm absolutely gutted about the back of the building there. That's out of order. Oh, I wonder when that happened. Oh. Anyway, so I've only explored this bit of this map, so hopefully when new biomes come, hopefully soon, there's that there, and then there's obviously this map here. I don't know how much of it, I can't remember how much I've explored it. In fact, I haven't even got a map for that one, or this one, or this one. because obviously it's 5x5. I know. Why have I explored that bit there? But it's just cut off there. I wonder if I was just next to the border. I don't know what's there. So yeah, I've not explored quite a lot. I do have a chance of if the update is where what happens is the just literally just any unexplored area, that's where you get your new biomes, then I'm happy. Because that'll just work out. That'll work out cool, that. But if it's just going to be interesting, because if it just overwrites whatever's there, I mean, it'll be fun when I load this up, and there's a spike, an ice spike going all the way through this building here. Now that would be a bit dangerous and a bit naughty of them. Oh, I'm gutted about all that. I heard him. Wonder what else has blown up, if anything. Is anything else blown up? Where are you? Oh, there he is. Not to worry. He'll burn. He'll burn very shortly. Right, let me just have a look. Because guess what I'm doing next? Guess what I'm doing next? My lord. Oh. How's it? Oh, there's something seriously gone wrong somewhere. Because that was fine because it's all slabbed and that's how I did that there. But. Oh, no way. Right, better start repairing that. So, if you like the video, please leave a like. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks for putting up with the devastation. I mean, it wasn't there when we drove past, surely not. When we came past. Because I turned around. I'll have a look on the video again, because that's I think something dodgy's gone on there. I'll work it out. Let me just see if I can't. It's not invisible, is it? A fall down, can I get out? No. I'll have a look in the video. Yeah, so anyway, thanks for watching. And if you're new, or if it's the first time you've watched one of my videos, do have a look at the previous ones. The first two, I think, are PlayStation, when you could first record on PlayStation, so the quality is not the best. But definitely everything after that, when I had the Elgato's, pretty alright to watch. So if you like, leave a like. If you like, subscribe, please do. And other than that, thank you for watching, and I'll speak to you again next time.